This time I am with another update video on the RTR. As it can be seen, my front tires showed some deep visible cracks all around, where some cracks were deep enough to make me paranoid. So before I go and share my experience with the new tire, we should know some of the factors that cause these cracks. One of the common factors is the age of the tire that dries out the polymer compound and makes the rubber hard and brittle-like. I did notice those on my 6-year-old car tires, along with cracks due to heat and UV exposure, which are minor surface cracks. No need to worry if you have those minor cracks on the surface, as they are potentially harmless for the tires. Other reasons for crack formation could be non-frequent use, not maintaining the tire pressure, and overloading the vehicle. Heavy impact on tires and weak structure can also cause cracks and bulge on the tires that can be dangerous. I believe mine was due to the prolonged non-use during the lockdown period, where I was away from my ride for more than 6 months. So every time I took my motorcycle out, these cracks were bugging me. Moreover, the rear tire is already new, so it made sense to get a new front tire. This time I did not think much and directly went ahead with the matching pair with the MRF Zapper FS, which I think was a decision made in hurry on a Saturday evening, as I had immediate ride plans the next day. Yes, I won't miss this chance to flex my new torque wrench adapter, which I used to torque the axle bolt after the tire installation. You can find the complete video for that in the description. To start with, my experience with the Zapper FS is surely better than the stock Remora, but definitely these are not the best tires out there. I have got that taste with Pirellis on the racetrack, and even MRF does knows how to make good budget sticky tires, as R15 version 1's tires were a good example for that. Both the stock Remora and the Zapper FS have got non-radial construction. Of course, these are the tubeless variant with the same speed and load index. The first change I noticed was with the braking, where the Zapper offered better stopping power. The dry grip is nothing to complain about, where it has got a decent performance. The unseasonal rain in December also gave me a taste of its wet road performance, where you have to lower your expectations. Mine is a non-ABS motorcycle, so things can easily get out of hand in wet conditions. Of course, we are asking for a lot from an 1800 rupees tire, but this combo does corners well in dry condition and is stable at high speeds with good absorption. MRF is known for making value for money products, and the Zapper FS is a testimony of the same. But for enthusiasts like you and me, I think the Masseter FX will be a better choice from MRF, with better wet performance and soft compound rounded profile tires to attack those corners. Well, as I said, it was a decision taken in rush, which kind of gave me a lesson for my next motorcycle purchase. So that's it for this video, and I hope you guys have liked it.